Hello everyone. So today we will be learning the continuation part of the marginal costing. So in the previous class we have learnt only till here, right? So this is a continuation. So we will be learning the formulas with the short tricks. So before that, let me explain you this format. Okay, if you remember this trick, everything is covered. Okay, it is easy to remember the formula as well. Okay, that is sales. From the sales, if you deduct the variable cost, you will be getting contribution. From that, if you deduct the fixed cost, you will be getting the profit. Okay, just remember these figures. Okay, that is 10 minus 6, it will be 4. Deduct 3, you will be getting 1. Okay, now if I ask you, okay, if I ask you how to find the contribution, how you will get this 4? That is from the sales if you deduct the variable cost. So this can be one option. Just check other ways whether you, how you can get the 4. Okay, see this number 3 and 1. If you add these two, you will be getting the contribution. That is fixed cost plus profit. I hope it is clear to you how to find the contribution. Okay, now let us move to the next one. Okay, that is profit. Now, how you can find the profit? Simple way, that is, if you deduct the from the sales, if you deduct the variable cost and fixed cost, you will be getting the profit, right? That is 10 minus 6 minus 3, it will be 1. Any other options? Directly also you can do, like contribution minus fixed cost. Okay, so these are the two ways you can find the profit. Now let us move on to the next formula, that is PV ratio. So PV ratio means, it is full form, it is profit volume ratio. So you can remember, like volume means it is sales. Okay, usually you will be forgetting the formulas, right? You can remember like this. See here, it is like we'll be writing PV, right? We'll be writing like this, na? Okay, it means you can remember like this. The subject is cost, right? The subject is cost and management accounting. So remember C. Okay, and my name is Shruti, right? So remember S. So it means contribution divided by sales. I hope it is clear to you. This is PV ratio. If you want it in percentage, then just multiply with 100. Got it? If you want it in percentage, multiply with 100. Okay, so PV ratio is equal to C divided by S, that is contribution divided by sales. Okay, one more way. I already explained you in the first, that is how to find the contribution. Sales minus variable cost. Okay, sales minus variable cost divided by sales. This can be also one more method to calculate the PV ratio. Okay, one more, that is instead of contribution we can write fixed cost plus profit. Same, right? Fixed cost plus profit means it is a contribution. You can do like this. Okay. Now if they give you 2-year information, then how to find the PV ratio? Okay, so formula will be changes in profit divided by changes in sales into 100. Okay, that is changes in profit divided by changes in sales into 100. So in the question, now what they will give you is, they'll be giving you sales, they'll be giving you the profit. Okay, how to find? They'll give you 2-year information. Just find the difference. Okay, think that sale is here 100. Here, assume here it is 200. What is the difference here? That will be the changes. Similarly, profit, assume here it is 10. Assume here it is 5. What is the difference here? 5. That will be the changes in the profit. I hope it is clear to you. So sometimes now in the question, instead of profit, they will be giving you the cost. By the time what you will do? In the question, they'll be giving you the sales and they'll be giving you the cost. Then how you will find the profit? The difference of this, that is sales minus cost, will be your profit. I hope it is clear to you. Example, if I take you, here it is 100. Assume your cost is 80. Assume here it is 200 and your cost is 190. Now you can find the profit, right? You can find the profit by differentiating. That is 100 minus 80 will be 20. This will be your profit. Similarly, 200 minus 190 will be 10. This will be your profit. So when you apply, how you will find changes in the profit means the difference of these 2 years information, profit of previous year and current year, that is 20 minus 10 will be 10. Similarly, sales 100 minus 200, that is difference of this will be 100. I hope it is clear to you till here. So we have learned contribution, then we have learned profit, and we have learned PV ratio. And one more thing, students. So if it is PV ratio, so if you remember these formula, okay, if you remember these formula, contribution divided by sales. If I ask you find the contribution, you have the PV ratio and you have the sales. Can you find the contribution? Yes, right. You can find the contribution by multiplying the sales with the PV ratio. I hope it is clear to you. See here, it is division, right? So when it goes in the left side, it will be PV ratio into sales. So this is what I have written here. A contribution is equal to sales divided sales into PV ratio. I hope it is clear to you till here. Okay. So let us move to the next formula, that is break-even point. Okay. Now how to remember this? Assume during break period, you went to KFC. Assume you went to KFC. Okay. Now, from the KFC, just delete this K, okay, which is remained your fixed cost. So remember, during break period you went to KFC. So remember, on the numerator it is fixed cost. On the numerator it is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Contribution per unit. It means from if you calculating break even point units, then it will be fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. You can remember, you know, in computer there is a CPU, right? It's the brain of the computer. So you remember like CPU. Got it. So break even point is equal to fixed cost divided by CPU, that is contribution per unit. I hope it is clear to you till here. Okay. Let us move to the next formula, that is break even point sales. Break even point sales. So when you calculating the break even point sales, okay, remember same thing, that is went to KFC. Assume from that you take the FC, that is fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Okay, so we have already learned what how to calculate the PV ratio, right? How to calculate the PV ratio. See here, the previous slide we have already discussed, and I told you the short trick also for the PV ratio. What is the trick that you should see? That is contribution divided by sales. I told to remember, like, subject is cost and who is teaching you? Me. That is Shruti. So contribution divided by sales. I hope it is clear to you. PV ratio means contribution divided by sales. So you can apply like this also. Instead of PV ratio, you can write contribution divided by sales. Okay. So I hope you all know how to find the break-even point sales. Okay. Let us move to the next. And I hope you all know this also, that is fixed cost divided by contribution. Okay. This division will be, it will be multiplication over here, that is contribution divided by sales. It will become sales, you have to multiply, contribution should be divided. Okay, you should see here, be careful here. Okay, this is same thing. Now one more thing, how to find sales. Okay, how to find sales. So contribution divided by PV ratio. Okay, contribution divided by PV ratio. This is from the PV ratio itself. Okay, that is, if I ask you how to find the sales, then what you have to do? Get this sales in the left side. It will be sales. Okay, sales is equal to contribution divided by this PV ratio will become division. That will be divided by PV ratio. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. Same thing I have written here also. Contribution divided by PV ratio. I hope it is clear to you till here. Okay, let us move to the, see, contribution only I have written in different ways. Okay, that is sales minus variable cost, fixed cost plus profit. This everything is same. Okay, that is contribution. Now let us move to the next formula. How to find the fixed cost? Okay, how you will get the fixed cost? How you will get this 3? Sales minus variable cost. Okay, sales minus variable cost will be contribution. From contribution, if you deduct the profit, you will be getting fixed cost, right? Okay, that is, if it is, oh sorry, make the changes here. This is not fixed cost, it is sales. It is sales. Sales minus variable cost minus profit. Okay, and one more way, fixed cost is equal to break-even point sales into PV ratio. You can see here break-even point sales, right? You can see the break-even point sales here. If I ask you how to find the fixed cost, what you will do? Break-even point sales. Okay, this division will become multiplication over here. Okay, that is break-even point sales into PV ratio. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, same thing it is over here, right? So break-even point unit, break-even point sales into PV ratio. PV ratio we have learned already. Same thing I have written in different ways. You can write it as contribution divided by sales. Got it? One more way how you can find the fixed cost is sales into PV ratio. Okay, sales into PV ratio minus profit. Sales into PV ratio means it is a contribution, right? So sales into PV ratio minus profit. Got it? Contribution minus profit. Now the last one, not last one, margin of safety. Okay, margin of safety means it is the difference between your sales and break-even point sales. Okay, so sales and break-even point sales, this you already calculated. I already taught you how to calculate, so you can do it. The difference of this will be your margin of safety. One more way is there, that is profit divided by PV ratio. Okay, profit divided by PV ratio. PV ratio already I have told you, that is cost, that is sorry, contribution divided by sales. Got it? I have written here same way. You can write like this also. Got it? I hope it is clear to you till here. Okay, now last two formulas are there, that is desired sales. So in the question, no, they will be giving you find the desired sales when there is a desired profit. Okay, in the question the desired profit will be given. Then how to find fixed cost plus desired profit divided by contribution per unit. Got it? Fixed cost plus desired profit. So you can say it as this total, that is fixed cost plus desired profit, means it is a total contribution desired divided by contribution per unit. Okay, the last one is desired sales value. See here, this is units, so whenever it is units, take it contribution per unit only. Okay, now if they ask you desired sales value, here it is unit, this is value, Then extra thing is you have to multiply with your selling price. You have to multiply with your selling price. Okay, I hope it is clear to you till here. So which are the tricks I have told you here is for the PV ratio, what I have told you? For the PV ratio, I told to remember the subjects, that is your cost and my name, that is Shruti. You can remember contribution divided by sales. And one more thing I have told you regarding the break-even point, right? I told you in the break-even point, during break time, you went to KFC, right? So fixed cost, and I told you, you remember the computer, that is brain of the computer, heart of the computer, that is CPU, right? CPU, that is contribution per unit. This is break-even point units. Okay, for break-even point sales, what I told you, fixed cost divided by, here it will be little changes, PV ratio. Here it will be PV ratio. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. If you have any doubts, kindly ask me. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.